If you're looking to build your team, make sure you head on over to cheapmaddencoins.com for the cheapest prices, fast delivery, and 24-hour customer support. And make sure to use code WOLF for 10% off. Yo, what's up, everybody? It's King Wolf. Welcome to today's gameplay. Now, today, I'm going to go over what I was doing against an opponent. Now, in previous video, man, I showed you guys how to stop mobile QBs. And one of the games that I played in regs was against someone who relied on his quarterback. Now, he relied on the run games. You can see here, Blunt just trucking everybody. I know that this guy has his running game set to aggressive. So what I should have done, and you should do when this happens, is set your strip ball to aggressive. I should have did that. That was my mistake. But you're going to notice here in this video that at the beginning, my man was rolling out with his QB. And for the most part, I would let him get away with a couple so he would keep doing it. And the reason I was doing that is because later I wanted to set him up to try to get a turnover off of it or to force him into getting sacked. You know what I'm saying? So we started playing a pass defense, and he started running it on us, so we started playing run defense right here on 4th and 7. He actually throws a good route right there. My man defense didn't kick in with that mid blitz, which I don't really use a lot anymore, but if you notice right here, this guy's just trucking me. His running is set to aggressive, so if you want animations like that, use Blunt and use that. But right here, I shot the gap, and I got him, and this was probably the turning point in the game. I think that shot right there kind of scared him a little bit. You'll see that he's going to roll out with his QB again. He's got nowhere to throw it. We're starting to play a lot of lockdown pass defense. He's going to come back to the run game on 3rd and 12, and he's going to try to truck me and all that, but we stop him. So it brings us up to a 4th down. Now, I'm playing pass defense right here. I'm waiting for him to roll out with his QB, and there I go. I'm going to attack him myself because I want him to still feel that he can roll out with his QB, because if he looks to that, then it's going to take a lot of time away from his pass game. So we get the interception. Now it's time for us to go to work. I'm going to go ahead and take him outside right here. Then I'm going to stay in the same formation and have him think I'm doing the same thing. But instead, I'm coming to the PA curls, and I love that A route right there against those defenses when they play hard flats, man. I'm going to show you guys a video here in a little bit. And right here with the Jai, man, we get the one play TD off the power O from the I-form set. Very good run play. I use it a lot now. I hadn't used it previously, but you know, I was using it a lot in Madden 17, but I came back to it. Now right here, he starts throwing a little bit of dots, man. The seam route right there is open. So I take it away. Now he's got someone up the middle of the field. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take the seam route and I'm going to take the middle away. I'm taking both of those away right here. Now I have a QB spy set up in case he wants to run. He knows the QB spy is there, and then someone breaks free, we get the sack. So here we go again. We're shutting it all down again. Same thing, got the QB spy going. I'm going to click the right stick in, straight for the QB, and he just tries to force a throw in there. Now it's 3rd and 22. We're taking everything away again because he wants to pass the ball. I got a QB spy. I'm going to go ahead and send him in now by clicking the right stick in. He tries to throw another forced pass, and yeah, that would have been a pick if it was a little bit more inside, but it wasn't. So he tries the onside kick. We're starting the third quarter. This guy has probably gone through a breakdown, a meltdown. The potato has come out. We're going to go ahead and do the same PA curls, and then he has the A route covered, so we're going to go ahead and hit the flat. That's why I run those together. He's going to have to pick one or the other. So it's 3rd and 1. We do the halfback wham, and we do not get the 1 yard. So we settle for the field goal because I'm all about the points, baby. I'm not about, you know, trying to look cool and whatever. I'm trying to get the W. You know what I'm saying? So he gets the ball back 10-0. He's going to start running the ball, but we're there. We're going to put a stop to the run. But these trucking animations with Blunt on aggressive is awesome, bro. So we're going to start going. We're going to go ahead and dial up the pressure right now in this series right here. You're going to notice that I'm running the pinch dog, and I'm dialing up the pressure. Boom. Now he comes out in a 3rd down, and I think this is the play right here is where he's actually going to get an open route. Yeah, he's got one right there up the seam. So I'm going to go ahead and back off of my pressure and then just play the coverage more. But now what we do different, instead of setting a QB sky and me waiting, I'm running QB contained. So now my guys are going to the outside and they're waiting for him. You know what I'm saying? So right there, we're adding another element by using QB contained and just hoping that they work. 3rd and 22, he's going to run it. I don't know why he did that. It's 3rd down. I guess he feels like he's just completely locked down as far as passing goes. But he had a couple good dots, and right there was a pick. And you'll see, you see the defense. You see what's going on, man. He concedes. And I just wanted to share this game with you guys on how to stop the mobile QBs and just lock your opponent down, man. It's very easy when you're facing someone that wants to run around with their QB. Anyway, man, drop a like on the video, subscribe to my channel. Check you guys out on the next one. Peace.